legend here. What did you find? Something dead. Perfect. A dead frog. Gross. Okay. Well, we're going to get rid of that. Goodbye, frog. Hi, I'm Kat with Standing Stone Kennels, and we've gotten this question a lot recently. How to transition from vibrate conditioning your dog to recall or going on a dog bed to using stimulation with your puppy. And in all of our puppy training series, we haven't really put a lot of emphasis on going over how we do that. And so we thought, you know, it's a good time to do that video. We've got Legend, who's basically right there needing this to happen now anyway. We just did his bird and gun introduction. He's 5 months old and he got that bird in his mouth. And with that level of excitement and distraction, vibrate was not enough to get him to recall back to me. He's usually super cooperative, especially with the collar on, using vibrate to recall to me. Not when birds were involved. So that was a good indication that he's ready for us to start using some stimulation. But in order to introduce that properly, we want to go back a step. And we actually start this conditioning process with stimulation in, again, a controlled environment with less distractions. The first time you use stimulation on your puppy, especially if you have to go up more than, you know, a low level, is not when you're trying to do a bird introduction or something like that, because they don't always associate the same pressure on, pressure off as they do with the vibrate to when we start using stimulation, and they can act confused, they can freeze, they can freak out. So if you can take the time to introduce that stimulation conditioning before you get into those high distraction situations, that's important. So first I'm just gonna vibrate him over to me. Legend here, what did you find? Something dead, perfect. A dead frog, gross. Okay, well, we're gonna get rid of that. Goodbye, frog. And then I also want to talk about properly fitting the e-collar, especially now that we're going to be starting to use some stimulation. Before, this thing, when it's vibrating, it can be a little loose and the puppy's still going to hear it, still going to feel it. Proper fit's still important, but it's even more important now when we're going to start using that stimulation, because these collar prongs need to make contact with their neck. We like it when our puppies behave calmly to get their collars put on and aren't fighting us the whole time. But we're going to get that put up behind the smallest part of his neck. Make sure it's nice and snug. I can get about 3 fingers under there. I've got small hands though, so 2 fingers might be all that you can get. And then I just tuck our collar strap up through here because our antenna runs the entire length of our strap with these DT Systems collars. And if I cut that, I'm going to shorten my range. So I've got that fitted. Good boy. And I'm going to just start building momentum in this session. We're not going to be using treats or anything like we were before when we were starting to vibrate condition him, because he already knows how to shut the collar off with vibrate. So I'm going to use a little bit of that vibrate to build some momentum, then start with low levels of stimulation. So just get him a little bit farther away from me. And this might be something that I end up needing an assistant to be able to call him back and forth between us. Here? Good. What are you eating now? Mulch. He's a puppy. Everything goes in his mouth, kind of like our son right now, our baby. He puts everything in his mouth. So a little bit of distance. Here? So here. He's being a little bit distracted because we do have a lot of sticks and mulch and dead frogs in the yard. So we're still going to have to work with him on vibrate first, build a little momentum, then introduce that low level stimulation. So Legend here. So as soon as I'm saying the cue here, he's feeling vibrate. Good boy. Okay. Let him run off again. Legend here. Good boy. As soon as he gets to me, the vibrate shuts off. Okay. Good. So then I'm going to use a low level of stimulation, starting with a 1. I'm going to be using continuous stimulation. Legend here. Legend here. Good. And I created some more separation. He was kind of stopping about a step or so away from me. And instead of me coming forward to meet him and reach for him, I'm just creating a little bit bigger gap where he has to actually continue to come to me and meet me. And the stimulation wasn't shutting off. So we were just using a 1. that's such a low level that he might not even honestly be feeling it. I didn't see any physical reaction, no neck twitch, no itching, no, you know, looking confused. So I'm gonna actually go up to a 2 on my next one. Legend here. So he's feeling a 2. He's not even paying attention. We're gonna roll the collar up just a little bit. Legend. Legend. Here. There, he's feeling it. Do you see his posture changed a little bit? Come on, Legend. Here. Come on. I'm going down. Hey, hey. Here. Here. Come on. Here. Here. Good boy. Good. So I got up, and he wasn't acknowledging the collar until we got up a little bit higher. He was ignoring me, and then he vocalized just a little bit. So I rolled the collar back down and kept continuous stimulation on to finish that recall. Okay. So we're back down just to a 2 again on the collar. Here. Good boy. That's good. Good. Okay. So we need him to understand how to shut the collar off even when there's stimulation involved, not just vibrate. Because a lot of times he can ignore vibrate when he's sniffing around in the yard. Legend. Here. Legend. Here. So he's feeling a 2. Good boy. Good. And he responded. So we need to continue proofing the collar. And what that means is, yay, he responds to a 1 or a 2 on the collar. But again, in those high distraction situations, a 1 or a 2 most likely isn't going to be enough to get his attention redirected and focused back on what I'm asking him to do. So I want to make sure that he's still going to be able to respond, not freeze, not vocalize, not freak out if he feels a little bit more stimulation. So I'm going to go up just another level, create a little bit of distance for us. Here. Come on, here. Good boy, good, good job. Good, okay. Again, Legend, here. Good boy, good job. So he's showing a good understanding of he can shut that stimulation off, just like he could shut the vibrate off, by complying with what we're already have taught him and he already knows, even when he's a little more distracted. Legend, here. So he's feeling the collar, still sniffing. I'm gonna go up here. Good. So again, I went up one more level because when I hit that 3 stimulation, he's still sniffing. He's still ignoring me. That means that he is still able to ignore that level of stimulation and do what he wants to do. And at some point, he's going to say, oh, that's more stimulation that I want to ignore. I'm just going to come when I'm called. So Legend, here. We can see a little bit of reaction. Good. Here. Good boy. Good. Good job. Okay. So this is how we go ahead and transition from vibrate conditioning to stimulation conditioning. And we call it proofing the collar so that they understand how to shut that stimulation off when we need more stimulation in higher distracting situations. Now he's being a little more clingy. There we go. Here. You can see he can feel it on his neck. Come on, here. Legend, here. Come on. Good, come on. Finish it. Good. So as soon as he gets to me, it shuts off. You could see his neck was a little bit twitching, so he could feel it. I could visually see that he could feel it, and he still wasn't quite responding. Once he started moving and had given in and acknowledged that he was coming, I didn't need to keep it at that 4. I rolled it back down to a 2. That's the nice thing about these collars. We have that ability to just roll the level of stimulation down when we're getting the desired response that we need to see. So good boy, Legend. Here, one more. Come on. Here, come on. That's a good boy. And this is important, not only when you're in higher distracting situations like doing your bird and gun intro or getting out in the field and he's on birds and chasing and super pumped up and excited. But this is also important for the safety of your dog. If your dog has only ever responded to the vibrate stimulation or vibrate on the collar, they're not always going to know how to respond to stimulation properly. And if the first time you need it is in a scary or dangerous situation, your dog's headed towards a road or something like that, that's not the time to be trying stimulation for the first time. So it's important to condition that behavior with stimulation, like the recall, when you've got a controlled situation and you can work through it with your puppy and they can understand and not act confused. So thanks for watching, and I'm glad we could answer your question.